Hi, this is Manoj Jagia. This is another lecture of Capsule Literature Series. The first question that I would like to discuss in this session is, the literary phenomena called the angry young men occurred in. So remember, this group, angry young men, and also the movement group, both these important groups came in the 1950s. Now, angry young men, this group included middle class British playwrights, and remember that John Osborne and Kingsley Amis were the leading figures of this group. Next question is, who are ape-like beasts in human form in Gulliver's Travels? So this is a very easy question. The ape-like beasts in human form were yahoos, and it is from the book Gulliver's Travels, published in 1726. Remember, there are another beast creatures which are Hohenhims. They are horses. And ape-like beasts in human forms were yahoos. They were ugly beasts in the form of human beings. And Hohenhims were intelligent horses. Hohenhims take the last part of the book, and yahoos cover the second last part of the book Gulliver's Travels. The next question is, who termed metaphysical poetry as affectation of big words, Fustian phrases, jingling terms and strong lines? Who said this about metaphysical poetry? So this was said by Robert Burton. Robert Burton is very famous for his encyclopedic book, The Anatomy of Melancholy. Now you must be remembering who Robert Burton is. So he said this about metaphysical poetry, that their poetry is affectation of big words, Fustian phrases, jingling terms and strong lines. Remember, Dryden said, Donne affects the metaphysics. This is also a very important line. Dryden said, Donne, John Donne, affects the metaphysics. The next question is, the relationship between signifier and the signified is. So the answer is, very simple, arbitrary. Arbitrary is something which is not fixed, not permanent. So the relationship between signifier and signified is arbitrary, not fixed. Anytime, if I give you a sign, if I give you a word, you may imagine of a different thing and somebody else may imagine of a different thing. If I talk about a snake, some people may think about a green snake and some others will think about a black snake. Sign, signifier and signified. These are the concepts given by Ferdinand D. Chaussure. And he said that the signified is the final meaning. The final meaning is never fixed. It is always something new. It can always change from person to person. So the relationship between signifier and signified is arbitrary. If you want more on these terms and if you want a proper and thorough knowledge on structuralism, post-structuralism, you can please join our literary theory class, wherein we have explained all the theories in detail, each and every theorist, and all the terms are taken up. And in very easy manner, you will find the explanation of all these terms. The next question is, who is the author of the Theater of Absurd? So the author of the Theater of Absurd, remember, is Martin Esslin. Theater of Cruelty is Antonin Artaud. And Theater Workshop, which talks about the working class theaters, is Joan Lidwood. Remember these three very important theaters. Theater of Absurd, Martin Esslin. Theater of Cruelty, Antonin Artaud. Theater Workshop, Joan Littlewood. Theater Workshop is about working class theaters. Next question. Memoir Club of 1920 was originally centered on two daughters of. This was quite a very direct and easy question. Now, first of all, when you see the year 1920 in British, you should directly come to Bloomsbury Group, Virginia Woolf and so on, the modernists. And so your Memoir Club of 1920 was originally centered on two daughters of. Now, two daughters of, obviously it will be Leslie Stephen, and Leslie Stephen was the father of Virginia Woolf and Vanessa Bell. So the answer is quite direct if you have this knowledge. Who was Virginia Woolf's father? It was Leslie Stephen. Leslie Stephen was also very famous. He was a writer, cum biographer. He was also a mountaineer. And Memoir Club of 1920 is mostly about Bloomsbury Group, founded by Virginia Woolf and others. The next question. Shropshire Tales are authored by. Now here you can be confused. There are two such kinds of works. First of all, you should know what Shropshire is. Shropshire is an area which consists of fields, small villages, and market towns. So Shropshire Tales are authored by Mary Webb. Mary Webb is an English romance novelist and the poet of the early 20th century. And Shropshire Folk Tales are written by Amy Douglas. So Shropshire Tales are written by Mary Webb. And Shropshire Folk Tales are written by Amy Douglas. This was not given in option, so there is no need to be confused. The correct answer is Mary Webb, Shropshire Tales. So in this session also, I have discussed the questions that were asked in Maharashtra SET 2021. So that's all for this session. Thank you.